This is the continuation of the first video. In the first video, I explained the definition of Riemann integral. Definition of Riemann integral. In the first video, complete video, I have explained the Riemann integral definition. Now, I consider some examples. How to define a Riemann integral? A function f(x) defined in a closed interval AB is said to be Riemann integrable, or it is simply integrable if a to b bar fx dx is integral a bar to b fx dx. This is called upper integral, this is called lower integral. If upper and lower integrals are equal, then fx is said to be Riemann integrable. Now consider some examples. First example is, if f of x is defined as 0 when x is rational, and 1 when x is irrational. So the function is defined like this, then show that f is not integrable. Integrable means Riemann integrable, not integrable in any interval AB. We take always closed interval. See, the problem is like this. Fx is defined as either 0 or 1. Show that f is not integrable in any interval AB. When do you say that f is integrable? If a to b bar fx dx is a bar to b fx dx. So, we need to calculate this, a to b bar fx dx, a bar to b fx dx. How do you calculate? Let us calculate this. First of all, what are the two conditions here? Fx is bounded. I take any closed interval AB, fx is bounded in A. Why it is bounded? Because fx has only two values here, either 0 or 1. So, fx is greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 1. It is bounded. And, now, what are the bounds of fx? 0 and 1 are the bounds of fx. Now, I consider AB is the closed interval. It is divided into n number of subintervals by this division. X0, x1, x2, etc., xr minus 1, xr, xn is equal to b by this division. That means it is divided into x0, x1, x1, x2, xr minus 1, xr, and xn minus 1, xn. This n number of subintervals. Suppose small mr, capital MR being the bounds of fx in delta R subinterval is denoted by delta R. Then small MR is lower bound, it is 0. Capital MR is upper bound, it is 1. Because in any subinterval XR minus 1 XR, in between these two we have infinite number of rational and irrational numbers. In between xr minus 1 and xr. So small mr is 0, capital mr is 1. Now, how to define a to b bar fx dx? It is called upper integral. It is infimum of capital S. Now, what is capital S? Capital S is sigma. It is sigma r is equal to 1 to n. Capital MR delta, capital S, upper sum. It is sigma R is equal to 1 to N. What is capital MR? Capital MR means M1 delta 1, M2 delta 2, sigma means M2 delta 2, M3 delta 3, etc. We have to take. But here capital MR is fixed here, 1 in any subinterval. Therefore it is 1 into sigma delta, 1 into sigma delta is B minus A. length of all the circuit boards. Therefore, what is this capital S B minus A? Infimum of capital S is therefore B minus A. So upper integral is B minus A. Now what is lower integral? A bar to be f of x dx. A bar to be f of x dx is supremum of small s. How to define small s? Set of all lower sums. Sigma r is equal to 1 to n. Small m r delta r. This is small s. This is small s. It is therefore sigma 1 to n 0 delta, because small m r is 0. Hence it is 0. And it is supremum of 0 means 0. Therefore, lower integral is 0, upper integral is B minus A. So what is your conclusion? Lower integral is not equal to upper integral. Hence, in any interval AB, if you take any interval AB, upper integral is B minus A, lower integral is 0. Hence, fx is not integrable. This is how we can verify whether the function is integrable or not. This is the first example. Now I consider one more function. Function is like this. It is called Dirichlet's function. It is Dirichlet's function. Example 2 it is. Let f of x is, it is 1 when x is rational. X is rational. And it is minus 1 when x is irrational. It is called Dirichlet's function. Dirichlet's function. Now, function is defined like this. 1 when x is rational, minus 1 when x is irrational. Verify whether fx is integrable in the interval 0, 1. Verify whether fx is integrable in 0, 1. Now, fx is bounded. First of all, fx is bounded in 0, 1. Why is it bounded? Because it has only two values, minus 1 and 1. Function is, any function is said to be bounded if it is less than or equal to k, greater than or equal to small k, for all x. It is greater than or equal to minus 1, less than or equal to 1. So it is bounded. And also, function, the interval is finite, 0, 1. So two conditions of Riemann integrability are satisfied. Now, we consider any division of 0, 1. Both interval is given as 0, 1 here. Suppose D is x0, x1, etc., xr minus 1, xr, xn minus 1, xn. B, any division of AB means 0, 1 here. What do you mean by this? And you take like this example as here, 0, 1 is divided into 0.1, 0.1, 0.2, 0.2, 0.3, and so on. These are the, this is one division of 0, 1. Now, we take small mr and capital mr be the bounds of fx in delta. What is delta? Some arc subinterval. Arc subinterval. Then, small mr is minus 1, capital mr is plus 1. You follow why small mr is minus 1? Because if you take any subinterval xr minus 1, xr, it has these two values, minus 1 and 1. Minus 1 and 1. When x becomes rational, it becomes 1. Irrational, minus 1. In any subinterval, xr minus 1, xr, the function at minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1, and so on. These are the values of fx. So what is the lower bound? Minus 1. What is the upper bound? Plus 1. Now, what is the capital S? Sigma 1 to n, capital M r delta. What is capital M r? 1. therefore it is sigma 1 to n 1 into delta r. So it is sigma delta r. What do you mean by sigma delta r? Length of the complete interval, sigma delta r. What is that? 1. Small s is sigma r is equal to 1 to n. Small m r delta r. It is sigma 1 to n minus 1 delta r. Because why minus 1? Small m r is minus 1. Minus 1. It is therefore minus sigma delta r minus 1. So, the upper integral is, how do you define upper integral now? Definition of upper integral. In the first class, I explained this one. Upper integral 0 to 1 bar fx dx is, it is infimum of set of all upper sums. What is the set of all upper sums? Set of all upper sums can be taken as this. All upper sums are 1 here. So what is this? 1. What is lower integral? It is supremum of set of all lower sums. What are lower sums? All are minus 1 here. Lower sums. Lower sums is minus 1. What is this? Minus 1. So lower integral is not equal to upper integral. Lower integral is minus 1, upper integral is 1. Hence the function, Dirichlet's function, is not integrable. It is also not integrable in 0, 1. 0, 1. Next is, prove that every constant function is integrable. Every constant function is integrable. See the result here. Every constant function is integrable. What do you mean by constant function? Let fx is equal to k for all x belongs to a. We will take closed interval a. Then fx is called constant. Prove that this constant function is integrable. For that, AB is the interval. We take AB as the closed interval. Let D is equal to x0, x1, etc., xr minus 1, xr, xn is equal to, or xn. B, any division of A. And small mr, capital mr be the bounds of fx in delta. What is delta? R sub interval. Xr minus 1, xr. Xr minus 1, xr. This is the R sub interval. Then, we set up two sums. Upper sums is defined as sigma capital mr delta r is equal to 1 to m. What is this? Say, we have taken small mr, capital mr are bounds of fx in delta r. But what is the functional value here? Fx is k for all x. Small mr is also k, capital mr is also k only. Therefore, it is sigma r is equal to 1 to n k delta r. K into sigma delta r is b minus n. K into b minus n. Another sum we take small s. What is small s? Sigma r is equal to 1 to n small m r delta r. But what is small m? Small m r is also k. Because function is constant here, fx is k. Delta r. K into, again sigma delta r is b minus n. Now, set of all the upper sums is k into b minus n only. Lower sums is also k into b minus n. Now, how to define upper integral? Upper integral is a to b bar x dx. It is infimum of capital S. And capital S is k into b minus a. Infimum of k into b minus a. It is k into b minus a. So upper integral is k into b minus a. What is lower integral? Lower integral is supremum of small s. It is also supremum of k into b minus a only. K into b minus a. See here. This upper integral is k into b minus a. Lower integral is also k into b minus a. So what's our conclusion? Fx is integrable. Hence, the function fx is equal to k. What is function fx is k? Constant function. It is integrable. Hence, every constant function is integrable. Now, one more result here. It states like this. A function fx is bounded in closed interval AB. Show that integral A to B bar K fx dx is K into A to B bar fx dx if k is greater than or equal to 0 and a bar to b k fx dx is k into a bar to b fx dx when k is greater than or equal to 0. Suppose k is less than 0, a to b bar k fx dx becomes k into a bar to b fx dx when k is less than or equal to 0. Similarly, a bar to b k fx dx becomes k into a to b bar fx dx when k is less than or equal to 0. When k greater than or equal to 0, a to b bar becomes k into a to b bar only. A bar to b k becomes k into a bar to b. But this is important. K less than 0, negative. A to b bar k fx becomes k into a bar to b fx dx. Similar, a bar to b k fx becomes k into a to b bar fx dx when less than or equal to 0. Now, for this, I drew one of these results and the second one is quite obvious. You can easily understand the proof. For this, I will take first one, proof of first one. See, the proof depends on this result. We have supremum of lambda A. Suppose A is any non-empty set. A is any non-empty set. Supremum lambda A is lambda into supremum A if lambda is greater than or equal to 0. And lambda into infimum A if lambda is less than 0. So complete proof depends on this. Supremum lambda A is lambda into supremum A when lambda is constant here, positive. Lambda is negative, supremum lambda A becomes lambda into infimum A. The proofs, the two proofs depends only on this result. Take first one. Consider A to B bar f of x dx. It is how to define infimum of k into capital S. I write here k. A to B bar k fx dx is infimum of k into S. Because how to define upper integral? Upper integral is infimum maximum of k into sd. It is equal to k into infimum of sd because k is greater than or equal to 0. It is k into infimum sd means a to b bar fx dx. Consider second one. Suppose k is negative, a to b bar k fx dx is. K fx dx is, it is infimum of k into small sd, a to b bar k fx dx, when k is negative. Because when k is negative, this k into small mr, k into capital mr, this becomes upper bound and this becomes lower bound when k is negative. Therefore, this k into sd, small sd becomes upper something, because k into small mr becomes upper bound. Correspondingly, k into small sd becomes upper sum. So a to b bar k fx when k less than 0 becomes infimum k sd. It is equal to supremum of, right here, it is k into supremum of small sd. What is the result? Say lambda is less than 0. Infimum of ksd becomes k into supremum of sd. It is k into, what is supremum of small sd? It is a bar to b fx dx. A bar to b fx dx. Therefore, a to b bar k fx dx becomes k into a bar to b fx dx when k is negative. This is the proof. We may use this result in while studying some further any result, we may use this one. Then you have to remember this result. A to b bar k fx becomes k into a to b bar fx dx. A to b bar k fx becomes k into a bar to b fx dx when k is negative. Next is Darboux's theorem. I think time is out now. I can make only 20 to 25 minutes video. And in the next video, I take Darboux's theorem. Okay? Go through the videos. If you have any difficulties, you can, anytime you can call me. You all of you know my number. You